So today I talked about the adoption of natural language processing in the healthcare space. It was about how the adoption of natural language processing or AI capabilities should happen in a regulated environment like pharma organization, because they are very traditional in using these capabilities or using these technologies. And at the same time, we have to educate them, mature them, and remove the fear that it is absolutely going to help you in improving the overall performance of the drug. At the same time, improve the decisions that you take and ultimately ensure that you are compliant from a regulatory perspective. So key takeaways, the first key takeaway is that healthcare or a life science industry is one of the industry which is growing at a very rapid pace when it comes to adoption of NLP or NLP data or unstructured data. At the same time, the second takeaway could be the fact that how you can ensure the smooth adoption or create a roadmap which can ensure the smooth implementation of NLP or machine learning across these pharma organizations. And finally, understand the fact that pharma organizations are also taking initiatives in these areas. So it's kind of a scenario where it's not just the techie companies who are investing in these technologies, but at the same time, these companies like healthcare are also major initiatives in it. So basically, in case of other industries to talk about first, I would go for a banking industry or a lending organization who are into a business of lending money to these large other organizations or startup. What happens is they tend to get into a contract which is almost 200 pages, 300 pages, and it becomes tough for a legal department or a finance department to keep up with their terms. So it is a key necessity of financial domain to understand what are the key clauses which are added as a part of the contract, and at the same time the clauses are verified, they are compliant from a fact that it is followed from a regulatory manner as well. So that is, I think, one of the domain which can be a significant significant buyer for NLP. In terms of pharma, I think one of the key application which I would talk about, which directly relates to the patient life, is around ensuring the safety of the drug. Now, what happens across the globe when a side effect is observed for a patient, either a doctor or a patient himself can call up the call center of the pharma company, or a doctor can create a case report stating that this is an adverse event which has been observed. Now, typically, if we observe the time frame that pharma organizations take, it takes almost 2 hours to process one document. So if we switch towards NLP, that time will be significantly reduced to, let's say, an hour or so, or let's say less than that, because if we ensure that the accuracy is quite higher for the frequency of documents or the chunk of a documents, then those documents will go without a review. But those documents where a death or a organ failure is mentioned, then probably that faster regulation and faster reporting of the adverse event will be happening. So I think when I look at LinkedIn for past 2 days, I think there is a trend which is going on in terms of art and artists. So if I see AI as art, artists can be anyone. It's not necessarily an AI artist has to be a geek coming from a techie organization. It can be anyone who has spent almost 20 years in banking domain, a hardcore banking guy, but at the same time has keen interest to be an AI developer. He can start from the scratch. So when I feel, it's not about a gender, it's about what you want to do. So whether it's a man or a woman, a boy or a girl. So what I feel, AI is kind of gender agnostic. So whosoever has a logical thinking to solve something which is going to impact significantly, I think that's the person will be ultimately the winner in the AI space, no matter what, from which country or which state he's coming, she is coming from, what gender it is. So I think all that doesn't matter. What only matters is, I think, the solution that a person is trying to bring onto the table. And I think that's what MLDS is doing. So I have been following MLDS for last 2 years. I mean, last year was the first edition, but I think this year it has grown bigger in terms of the talks. So I think in terms of a mixture of professors coming from universities of Singapore, I think there is one speaker who is coming from abroad. At the same time, guys like Ugam or Analytica who are trying to pitch in their product and try to understand how we can leverage their expertise. So I think it's a combination of helping each other and get into a win-win situation. And at the same time, the students who are enthusiasts in AI, ensuring them that the doubts are demystified from their mind. And I think that's a great job that MLDS is doing. And I think if the opportunity is given, I think probably next year maybe I'll speak again on some different topic.